Okay, this is the site of EIA, okay, eia.government/petroleum/supplyweekly. This is the site of APA, American Petroleum Institute. Okay, you need not actually go to this. Rather, the best option would be to go to oilprice.com, as I mentioned. Okay, so I'm attaching the link of this alongside on the PPT also. So this is oilprice.com, and this particular editor, she always actually updates whatever is needed. So only thing that you had to Google is very much simple. You Google API crude inventory data on Google. API crude inventory data, also mention oilprice.com. Google API crude inventory data oilprice.com. So first search itself, her article would come on oilprice.com, and here we actually get the complete inventory data. I'll tell you what a complete inventory data consists of. For that, let me just take out an Excel first. Yeah, so this is what is being done for today. Today's date is 16th, right? Yeah, 16th September. So first of all, I realized that. So let's kind of name this first one as crude. Okay. Then the next one we can give it as gasoline. And the next one we can actually give it as distilleries. Okay. Now, what should be done is first one based upon API data. Here you can mention as total crude inventory. So API data, when it kind of comes to API data, it is showing me that to say a draw in crude oil inventories of 9.5. Okay, or every time this article is going to be in the same format. Okay, so kindly note that every time this article is going to be in the same format. So once you do, it will be pretty much direct. I'll kind of share the link of this article, but understand every week it is a different article. Today is September. Okay, September 15 because other timing. Okay, she released it much more earlier. So our time would be somewhere around 2 a.m. Okay, so crude, let's mention the values. She mentioned that there is a draw of 9.517, right? So minus 9.517. Now, when it comes to let's look at gasoline now. So APA reported a built-in gasoline inventories of 3.762, so which is nothing else but positive 3.762. So there has been a built-in gasoline inventory, 3.762 million barrels. Now distillate inventories. Okay, distillate inventories, which is down by 1.123 million barrels. So down by 1.123 million barrels compared to last week's 2.293 million barrel build. Okay, so that means this is negative, right? Down. So down means it is a draw. Inventory is down by 1 point. So just read this down. Down means it is a draw, right? So I can mention this as minus 1.123. Okay. So let me basically check out what is the total crude inventory now. Plus, plus this. So which accounts to negative 6.878. So this is the, what do you call? This is the current total crude inventory in the case of API. Now I am yet to release, I am yet to receive the EA data, which would basically come out at what time? 8 p.m., right? So at 8 p.m. I would basically get to know where is it? Yeah, so at 8 p.m. I'll kind of get to know the crude oil inventories. I'll kind of get to know what is the gasoline, what is the distillates. Okay, everything I'll be kind of getting to know at 8 p.m. So I'll just wait till then. And so let's say that in a factor of maybe some 5 minutes. Okay, so I would kind of wait for like some 5-15 minutes, okay, before initiating a position. I'll tell you why also. Now let's kind of talk about a case. Okay, let me just kind of talk about a case So now let me just talk about a case. Now I am realized that there is a total crude inventory draw minus 6.87. Now when I sum up all the values that I receive after 8 AM, let me just tell you that total inventory draw is just minus 2 million. That means expecting a draw minus 6.8 million, price has actually picked up of crude. If it is just minus 2 million, then definitely price should correct a bit, right? So that means that could be a shorting opportunity. Now let's kind of assume that total crude inventory data, it had been mentioned that it was a draw of minus 6.878 million. However, there is a total draw of minus 9 million. Then what could happen? Then possibly crude oil could actually pick up in value. It could actually pick up in value further if it is actually a draw of maybe some minus 1.2, sorry, minus 12 million. Meaning expected was a draw of minus 6.8, but actually is minus 12. That means the price could rally much upper. Now let's assume that expected was minus 6.878 draw, but actual release according to EIA is a build of 2 million. Think about that. People felt there was a shortage of minus 6.8, but there is an actual build of 2 million. Now the price should fall down, right? So this is a logic based upon the fundamentals. Now we kind of need to get the data, and that is actually what we would be waiting out for now. Okay, let's see what happens at 8. Now, one more thing I just wanted to mention to you is, so even though right now we are actually talking about looking at the fundamental side, so our community members, we never initiate any position purely based out of fundamentals because it is very much risky. Now let's talk about a case where we, when we are getting this data at 8 PM, it shows that so even though we see that there is a huge draw now, but as we mentioned, there is just a draw of, let's say, minus 2 million. That means there is a potential for the price to actually fall down, right? So we would check out for shorting opportunities maybe when some sort of support is getting broken, provided a good risk to reward ratio setup is pretty much possible. So we use it alongside price action. We interpret these charts alongside price action to get the best results. And this is not just purely based out of fundamentals, that we are ever going to initiate any sort of position. So kindly note, whatever is being mentioned now, it is purely the fundamental side. The trading side, definitely you need some sort of experience with price action and understanding levels, trend lines, managing risk efficiently in order to get the best results. Now let's say that a crude oil inventory draw is much more higher than what we saw now, let's say minus 12 million, then the price could actually pick up. Still, we'll look out for a long opportunity maybe once there is a breakout post a resistance. So that is how your trading approach should be. Never ever trade purely based on fundamentals, or never ever trade purely based on, especially when you're trading. You can invest based on fundamentals, but don't trade based on fundamentals purely. I personally feel this is my personal approach. Maybe your approach could be something else, but this is what kind of works for me. Let's see what happens at 8.